And now tap on move to profile, and here when you tap on back to home, you will be getting back to the home page. So yes, this is it, that simple, how we can move from one screen to another in Flutter application. In this vlog, we will try to see how to navigate from one screen to another in Flutter application. So now let us try to see the basic way how we deal this in Flutter programming. Import material.dart, and also before getting any further, you need to add the get dependence under your pubspec file, and you need to run the command pub get to just make sure that your dependency is being configured to your project. And you are good to go. And now let us also import the get.dart here. So if you are following the series of GetX tutorials, I think you are very much familiar with this basic configuration. Specify void main, and inside which let us provide the run app. And here we are considering a default class my app. And now let us consider a stateless widget here, which is my app, and we will be returning a get material app and not a normal material app. Here we are trying to return a get material app, and we have discussed this topic in our previous tutorials, so you can just refer that why we are using get material app here. So here I am considering get pages. These are the list of pages we need to specify here. For example, we are having a screen like profile. Here we are having a stateless widget profile, and you need to import material.dart here. And now I will be returning a scaffold, inside which body we can just, I'm just considering a text widget now, and inside which I'm specifying profile screen, and just make it to the center. So we are having a profile screen, and from the home screen we are trying to move to the profile screen. In the get pages, I'm going to specify the same here, get page, and here you need to specify the name. So I will be specifying the name like profile. So for the page, I will be considering profile. So just now we have created, let's import this, and here you can see we are getting the profile page now. And likewise, you can add different pages here. For example, you are having settings page, about page, you can just add them here and specify in the same format as I have specified. And to make it much flexible, you can just create a class separately. So I'm going to specify this as roots, and here let's specify our roots so that there will be no confusion actually. So here let us specify static final roots, and we will be specifying our roots over here. Here get page. So here you can see we have got an import get.dart here. So if you have not found it, you can just manually import it. And let's specify profile, which we have done previously also, and now redirect to profile page. Also import profile. So now you can just specify it here like roots dot root. So here import this one, and that's it. So now you are good to go. And also we have got some error here, so you need to add a semicolon. And so yes, we have got a profile page, but also we need to have a home page. So from home page we are going to the profile page. So now let's create a stateless widget home page, and here I'm going to return a scaffold, and inside which I'm going to provide an apper and title to be text. So using a text widget, I am going to specify a home page, and inside the body consider a center tag, and inside which I am going to specify a text widget again, which is showing home. And now in the roots, let's specify the same again. So I'm just pasting it, and I will be leaving it as empty and provide it as home. And let's import this also. I will be specifying initial root. So now let's try to run this code and check the output. So just we have got a home here. So this is our home page. And now instead of the text field, we will be making it as a text button, so that we can tap on this and move to the next page. Let's specify a text widget so that we can provide the name here. Move to profile. Okay, so inside which now we can just specify get dot to, and now you need to have get dot dot file. So just you need to import this. So every time you perform an operation using get library, so to make use of the get widgets, you need to import this get dot dot file, and just you can specify profile here. That's all, simple and so easy to use. So this will redirect you to that particular profile page. So now let us try to refresh the code and see the output. So here we got a button move to profile, and when you tap on this, you will be moving to a profile screen. So here we have got a profile screen now, and from profile screen we need to come back again. So just add an apper here, and inside the title let's specify profile. So yes, you have got an apper now, and by tapping on the back button you can get back. And also if you want to have a button click for coming back also, you can just replace the text widget here. So here also we will be considering a text button. We need to get back to our previous screen. So let's specify child also using text widget. You can just specify back to home here. Just make use of get dot back. So just like we did, you need to import the get, and yes, you're now good to go. And now try to refresh the code, and also here you can make use of the named routing. So just comment this line and get dot to. Here you can see we have got an option to name. So instead of profile, you can just specify this profile. So we have specified a roots class, right? So using which we can make use of it now. And here you can see to, let's tap on this, and also this works similar to our previous example. And again, it's a choice for you to use any of this one. And now let us see what are all the other configurations available now. So what are the other things you can do here? As we discussed in our previous tutorials, whenever you are having any query, what are all the other things you can do with the help of an example, you can just tap on the documentation here. So here you can see we have got transition, curve, duration, full screen dialog, arguments, binding, and all these kinds of options available with this. So now let us see some simple things like transition now. So you can just provide a transition. So instead of no transition, I will be providing like fade in or left to right. Let us use this one. And now try to rerun the code. So every time I am trying to rerun the code just to make sure you understand the changes we are trying to make to the code. Let's tap on the move to profile, and here you can see our profile page will be loading from left to right now. So here you can see our screen was moving from left to right. And also let us specify the duration here. Duration in terms of seconds I am specifying. So let's specify 10 seconds. So in general we don't use 10 seconds, but let us try to see. Here you can see we are trying to load the new page. Just to make sure you understand how the transition is working, I have specified 10 seconds. And you can also make it right to left, and let's try to reduce 10 seconds. We can't wait for that much amount of time. And now let's tap on the move to profile, and here you can see our page is coming from right to left. And when you click on back to home, it is moving from left to right. So these are the basic scenarios we use mostly. And also you have some more like opaque arguments, binding. So depending upon your requirement, you can make use of all these things. And also there are more transitions, you can just go through them. And I hope you understand this tutorial. I'll be providing the code for this tutorial in the description section below. And I also suggest you to go through our previous tutorials on GetX library to make sure you understand how we are using get material app instead of material app, and remaining concepts regarding GetX library to just make it easier for you to understand how we are doing this. If you like this tutorial, do like, share and subscribe to our channel for more interesting content on Flutter.